Whoa, lordy, lordy. Look at that thing. Tell me that's not a fighter, hey? Look at that. Look at that. That is a slab, dude. Oh, yes. There's nothing wrong with that, boy. Nothing wrong with that. I don't care where you fish, man. You catching crappie like that. A little hair jig. Look where he's got the little Popeye jig. Look at that, man. The meat, the plastic, or the hair jig? Which is it? A lot of people have been asking me about different baits to use for crappie. They watch our series, they watch our YouTube channel, and see that we use quite a bit of variety of different things, from crank baits to twitch baits, even some topwater waking, blade baits, and a lot of plastics, because we all know plastics work. Now let's make sure we understand. We all know that live bait, any type of minnow, will catch crappies. Whether you're fishing deep, shallow, under a float, single poling, dragon, I don't care how you're fishing them, they do catch crappie. But this is about the angler who wants to fish with artificials. He doesn't want to get his hands all scaly, doesn't want to get his rod all kinds of minnow scales on it and stuff. He just wants to catch fish, and I can guarantee you there are scenarios where the hair jig and soft plastics will totally outproduce minnows. I'd say 100 to 1. Take that to the bank, because I've been fishing a long time and I know it does that. Cold water conditions, spider rigging and stuff, yes, absolutely. Live bait, meat does prevail. But when you're going one-on-one or under a float and you found those crappie either spooked in clear water, pre-spawn, or they just don't want to eat something big and flashy, plastic cranks or whatever, they will eat a hair jig. This is all about the hair jig, a couple options on how to fish it, so you can catch them too with something other than meat or the plastic. Now there's something about using the right float. You know, it's called almost like a pencil float. It's balsa wood. But I mean, almost no resistance whatsoever. When the fish are aggressive and they pop the float, knock the float, and it goes all over the place, that's one thing. But when you get a light bite with a small jig, like the Popeye jig, on the float, you want something that's streamlined, so they just knock it and it just goes right down. They feel nothing. They hold on to that jig and help you catch fish. Should I get their attention? Put it in. A few little knocks. Again, all about finding them on a tree. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh yeah, look at this. Dudes. A waker. See, what's a waker? Well, it's waking me up and it's making a wake all the way to the boat. You have to twitch it a few times. Wake him up. And then when he's seen the Popeye jig, easy boy. What's wrong with you, man? You got bad attitude. Look how we ate it again. Hey, look at that little jig right up through the top. There's no way, no way that that fish is coming off. Unless he got stuck on brush, which he did a little bit. But just another good eater, huh? Man, oh man. I love bobber fishing. He's just an eater. We got some real big guys. Take some pictures and stuff. But I mean, for eating, how can you beat it? Love it. And how can you not use a little hair jig like the Popeye? Sharp little hook tied directly to my line. And I put a little split shot on there too, because I want my float to sit totally vertical. Remember, that's only 1/16th ounce, okay? So it takes quite a bit to get the float. Otherwise, the float sits like this. A lot of times when the float's in the water like that, it'll lay down from fish that eats it. So I want that tension of the small split shot to be totally vertical. So my bobber is where it should be. Oh, wow. I tell you, man, when those fish are deep, like we're sitting in 3.9, okay? And I got my blades in about 7 feet of water. But with a tree like this, you can see the angle it's sticking up the trees, the branches, right? So it's going down like that. And I've only got my float set with the stopper about 18 inches, maybe 20 inches. So you know they're sitting in those trees, just like you see the paintings and pictures of crappie all sitting in there. It lands that little Popeye jig, little hair, by me twitching the thing, just subtle, just little twitch, twitch, let it sit. it's violent. You see how the float goes whoa, like right down. They're not coming up and just like taking it and going. They're like racing the other crappie to it. So you position the boat with the power poles, stay back, see where the trees are angling down, and then put your casts right where you think they could be sitting on the tree, sort of like this. Let's see. Right about there. Is there one there? Yep. Oh my goodness. Wow. Isn't that wild? Isn't that wild? Crappies, I love you, man. I love you. Because sometimes when you figure it out, and trust me, there's days, man, I go out like anybody, boy, and it's like pulling teeth, wisdom teeth, to get bit. But on days when you can catch decent crappies, that's maybe 11 inch, you're lucky enough, big enough, you got a small mouth, I'll let you go. But when you can catch them, that's what a hair jig looks like. There's so many different models on the internet, independent tires, companies, you name it. These guys who tie these up all over Facebook and Instagram, Twitter, you can't go a day without seeing some fantastic different examples of different hair jigs. We like the little ones with the big eye, the big jig, small little hook, super, super sharp. Sharpness is number one, because whether you're fishing under a float or fishing single pole, sometimes it can be some of the biggest crappie of the year. So you gotta make sure that the hook is solid, okay? I'm not talking about a real thick gauge, I'm just talking about very ultra sharp, where it just sticks. I call it like sticking into concrete or sticking into granite. When you drop it, it'll stick. There are hooks like that. Buyer beware. There are ones that are very cheap on the internet. Don't break your heart, because sometimes they actually crack at the shaft as well. So it's up to you what you want to buy. We like the ones that actually catch crappie and not just have them inhale it and then the hook breaks and you're heartbroken as well. So think about what you buy. But the different hair jigs on the market, there's all types and all colors, but just pick the different ones that give you confidence, because at the end of the day, this is what it's all about. You having confidence in catching crappie with baits like the hair jig. Whoa, lordy, lordy. Look at that thing. I mean, that's kind of fighter, hey? Look at that. Look at that. That is a slab, dude. Oh, yes. There's nothing wrong with that, boy. Nothing wrong with that. I don't care where you fish, man. You catching crappie like that, a little hair jig. Look where he's got the little Popeye jig. Look. Now, when you're throwing a hair jig, think about the soft, slender bite floats, okay? I like the ones that are more streamlined, okay? You see me use the bubble ones as well, but the streamlined ones, great option. The ones guys use a lot for steelhead, another fantastic option, okay? I rig it so it's just below the water line, okay? So maybe half inches above the water. Really easy to detect soft bites, pulls, and the crappie don't even feel the hair. And last but not least, you know it, man. It's that little cheap one that you can pick up at all the big box stores on the internet. You know, little styrofoam little thing, but they work. They're excellent when using hair jigs. Think about the bobbers that are out there. Use the ones that you want to use to give you confidence, like I said. But just think, have some variety in your boat, depending on the conditions, wave conditions, current, the depth you're fishing. The floats can be your best friend or worst enemy. Beautiful, beautiful, awesomely designed little bait. Little hair jig. Wow, I'm using pliers, man. You know that you got it good when you got to use the pliers. Just bend it and turn it. But that's the kind of fish I came for right here, right there. And this little bait, I mean, dudes, set up on a light bite right there. That with that is sore lip mamal. Where you're fishing, you know, it's all angler preference really. But I like the light tones, something natural, white, grays, a little bit of blue. If the water. Oh, that's another good one, Josh.
Yep, I'm right here this time.
Oh, wow. Thanks, man.
No problem.
That was ghost fishing again, dude, just in front of the boat.
That's the way to do it, eh?
Ghost fishing. But you know what I do? I pitch it out and I hold it with my other hand, Josh, so the jig is going really slow. Because I've watched these fish, they don't really want to chase, but if you go slow and stop it,
they want it.
I did it exactly there, and it's, as soon as I stopped the jig, tick. So I know you followed it out decent, but we got a few more like that for pictures, don't we, Josh, eh?
Oh, yes, we do.
All right.
A few more to come.
Well, for fun. Go on, boy. Wow. I tell you, man, this is just incredible. Catch them this way. One-on-one.
This is too much fun.
Crappie. If the water's off color, I'll go to the bright chartreuses, something with brown, greens, you know, black with different contrasting colors like pink or white. Totally up to you. But think about the little hair jig when you pick up that jig pole, because when they see this, man, oh man, they eat this. There we go. Netter?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. Bring him around, Josh. Bring him around. Let's bring him this way. Hey, there you go.
There you go.
That's a plate, man. Are you kidding? Definitely netter.
Oh.
Wow.
Nice one.
Now you tell me if that is fun.
That's beyond fun.
Now, are hair jigs the only answer? Absolutely not. Being a versatile crappie fisherman is key to catching them on different bodies of water, different conditions, different times of the year, water temperature. There's a lot of factors involved, but having hair jigs in your boat, again, just go on social media and watch how many guys tie up little hair jigs. Deadly color combinations, anything you want they can tie up, because they know these little hair jigs have caught crappie way before you and I ever picked up a jig pole or a float. Think about the hair jig next time you're fishing. They do catch crappie. Thanks for watching our video. Hope you put your comments below. Hope you subscribe, and we'll see you somewhere, anywhere, as long as you're fishing for crappie. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.